Bandwidth for this podcast is brought to you by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Welcome back to MacBreak Studio. I'm your host, Mark Spencer. With me is Steve Martin. We're talking about the Final Cut Pro 10.0.3 update and some really cool, underpinnings of the app, but a really interesting, useful stuff, right?
Yeah, the features that are kind of like in between the cracks of multicam and green screen, but are nonetheless really important to this update. In fact, Apple comes out with so-called incremental updates, 0.01, 0.02, 0.03, and there's like major,
they're big
features, they create a lot of work for me every 3 months. Yeah.
And to the point that 10.0.2 wasn't very much. The 0.1 was big, the 0.2 was like, okay, a little bug fix stuff, but this one, huge new features and other things that you've been digging up that don't sound like a big deal at first.
Digging.
And then you find out they're like intrinsic to your workflow.
Oh my gosh,
So what do we got today?
Well, let's continue our thread of discussing this database-driven application. Final Cut Pro is not just a content creation application, it's a content management system. We looked at in a previous episode that databases handle everything. You have a project database, you have little clip databases.
Right, the event database.
Uh-huh. Yeah, all your changes are essentially recorded by the app as you make them.
Okay.
Little instruction sets. Now, there's the metadata that the app creates, and then there's the metadata that you create. User-created metadata.
Okay, are you going to show us an example?
No, I'm just going to let you hang it out there.
I didn't know if I was going to. I'm creating metadata when I'm working in Final Cut.
Yeah, you can.
Even though I didn't do it. Even though I didn't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
In fact, you create metadata all the time with regard to searching clips, for example.
Okay.
All right. Let's look at an example. I'm going to do is well, but let me preface something. What I want to say is that you can now search favorites and rejects, and we'll talk more about that what that means as we go. But let me just go ahead and pick a.
Can I search my favorite rejects?
Yes.
Are my rejected favorites?
Yeah, you can actually.
Right.
So what I want to do is I'm going to go my favorite shark shot here,
okay.
And I'm going to create a range. Let's say I'm going to mark this range as a favorite. Okay. As soon as I click I can F or click the little favorite range here, and I do that, and I get a little green bar saying that's a favorite.
Yep.
Okay. I've essentially added metadata.
Okay.
My user-definable metadata, that's a favorite now that can essentially be searched or filtered, which we'll look at in a second. I can go down here and what's my drafts. I'm gonna create a selection here. And let's say I want to save that section as
a
favorite.
And you could just tap I and O to save
Or I could hit, in this case, I'm just F, right? So
okay.
I got two favorites. Now, if I wanted to find these favorites, let's say I have hundreds of clips here.
Right.
Previous to version 10.03, I had to use this little clip filter up here where I say, just show me all my favorites, okay? The downside of this method, I mean, it's not bad, but what if it was like a 20-minute clip? The thing is that these favorites make no distinction. It just says favorite. I can name them and I could filter them, but I can't search vis-a-vis text.
Okay.
And I'll show you what I mean.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is I am going to go back to all clips.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to name this this favorite. In fact, you just select it. Now, this is the user inputted. I'm changing
I'm
giving metadata. Right.
Okay. So this, by default, it says favorite, but you can actually change what that text says.
Right.
And it'll still be flagged as a favorite, but now it has some different text that is.
Did I spell giraffes right? Yes.
Giraffes, yes.
Long neck giraffes.
Okay.
Okay. And let's see, the hammerhead that was shot. Maybe that little favorite was an important one. Maybe I want to call this. This was shot in the Sea of Cortez, let's say.
And the favorite just refers to that range,
right? Now
clip range.
The beauty of these favorites, of course, if you select them, it just calls up that range.
Yes.
Now, like I said before,
it's sort of like a subclip.
Right. So it is like a little bit of a subclip. It's a predefined range, saved range. Now you could look at favorites this way, but what's new?
And even though you've changed their name, it'll still show you the favorites by doing what you did before.
Correct. But what's new is this. Notice I closed the triangle. I can't even see. But now I can search the metadata, the user input metadata.
That you typed in.
Right. Okay. So I can type in long, and it knew that text was part of long neck giraffes.
Okay.
So it pulled that up.
When you type in something in the search field there, it's searching on
text.
any text associated with a clip in the event browser, like the file name or the favorite name?
That's a good question. Let me show you what it's actually searching.
Okay.
If I click on this little magnifying glass, it brings up the filter. What it's showing you is by default, whenever you enter anything in this window up here, it's searching by text, which includes the name of the clip, but it also includes, well, you know, descriptions. If you put in comments, descriptions, and in this case, it included, it considered now that favorite a name.
Okay, and so, that's the new thing in the 10.0.3 update.
Correct.
That includes the text that you use for favorites.
Exactly.
Okay.
But it also
works. Useful.
I think it's very useful. Before, you could only find your favorites vis-a-vis this pop-up, but now you can name them, and the search now
just
recognizes
on those words.
Them.
Yes, that's great.
Exactly.
Okay.
And you can also, you essentially can do the same thing for rejects. Like, you can come in here. I'm going to use your, like you said, the I and O. Key instead of the dragon. I just like dragging this. But just maybe like you just hate that horse nose or a horse. You just hate horses.
Like
you just
never use this particular
horse.
Clip.
You can of course reject it.
Yes.
Right? And then you can say you can give this, you know,
it could be revealing a logo, or it could be you know, some talent showing
bad,
on the left side of the face. Like
bad
never,
horse.
The horse doesn't like his right side. Right. So this is my bad side.
Yeah, bad horse side, right? So, I mean, I can name it now. Same thing. I can go up here and I could just type in bad, or I can type in horse. And it will locate the look, it's to locate the rejects.
Nice
feature.
Yep.
One other nice feature I want to show you. That, again, little thing makes your life easier. In terms of searching, I'm going to go to switch to a different event. I'm going to go to reenactors, because the reason I'm going here is because there's four main types of clips that you could work with that are like container clips, or like their own little mini timelines. One is a compound clip.
Clips. Yep, absolutely.
The other one is a multi-cam clip.
Multi-cam clips now.
And
yep.
There is a new one called a stacked graphic or a layered graphic
like
clip.
Like a PSD file.
Right.
Yeah. Okay.
And then audition clip.
Oh, audition. Okay.
Right.
Okay,
so
that makes sense.
Right, makes sense.
Four different kinds. Right.
Now, what's nice for searching, again, if you click the magnifying glass and I go to this little plus, this little pop-up, I'm going to add a rule, clip type.
Okay.
And now you'll see under audition.
That's new.
This
right?
is new.
That new metadata type.
Yeah, in fact, right now it's looking for an audition clip. Look what it brought up. It brought up one of my audition clips.
Yes.
Okay. But let's say I want to find all my compound clips.
Okay.
Look. Just like that, these are all my
compound clips.
This is huge. I'm telling you, huge. It's great.
I can see where I would totally use this, because often I have everything organized by keyword collections. And if you create, like, if you create a new multicam clip, it won't show up in any of those keyword collections.
Right.
And so, where is it? Instead of going to the whole event and scrolling through them, you can just make a filter or a smart collection
for multicam
based on clip type.
Right. So if I choose multicam, it brings up my multicam.
Oh,
clip.
And then you can click new smart collection, and then it will, anytime you create a new multicam clip, it will automatically show up there.
Exactly. In fact, what I tell people is that smart collections are really nothing more than saved searches.
Yes.
That's all they are. So I can just say MC or for multicam clips, okay?
Saved searches that automatically update based on when you change data.
Right. So anytime you create a multicam clip, it will automatically
show up in
that smart collection.
Sweet.
Again, because Final Cut Pro is a database-driven app that's based on metadata that either you assign or the app assigns, it's just really takes the drudgery out of looking for stuff.
Yes, yes.
And so that's all I have to say about it.
Well, that's a great tip.
Yeah,
thank you.
It's fun.
Okay. More tips and training at rippletraining.com. Mm-hmm. So rippletraining.com.
We've got a lot of great tutorials up there, a lot of really Final Cut, compositing, green screen.
We've put out a lot of content.
Bunch of stuff,
So thank you. Mm-hmm. And thank you for watching MacBreak Studio.